I have long been passionate about pedestrian safety. I see it as a basic form of human travel and a right that we all have to walk safely in our communities and our cities. My name is Victoria Barrett, and I'm a transportation planner with the Chicago Metropolitan Agency for Planning. CMAP works with our local and regional partners as well as federal partners on topics related to transportation and land use. Pedestrian safety is a critical issue today, and speeding is an epidemic in our country right now, and pedestrians are particularly at risk. One of the things that drives me is the right to walk for our children, and that became very personal for me when my daughter was in fourth grade, and I wanted to show her and give her the skills she needed to walk safely in our community.
My name is Daisy Singh, and I'm with the Roadway Safety Foundation. The Roadway Safety Foundation is a charitable educational foundation dedicated to reducing traffic fatalities and roadway crashes through better roadway design and engineering.
Unfortunately, we're seeing a steep increase in pedestrian-related crashes. In 2020, during the pandemic, we had about a 4.8% increase in these deaths over 2019 levels. And when you factor in the fact that there was so much less travel going on, the pedestrian fatality rate, according to the Governor's Highway Safety Association, actually skyrocketed over 20%, which is really unprecedented. My name is Bruce Hamilton. I'm the managing director of the Roadway Safety Foundation. We think that engineering is one of the key elements of designing a safe system. We can do a lot more to be building safe environments through infrastructure improvements and design and technological enhancements.
There are a lot of emerging technologies that keep our pedestrians safe. Some of those are real technological advances, like the FHWA's STEP technologies. Pedestrian hybrid beacons and leading pedestrian intervals are two examples of technologies that are improving pedestrian safety. A leading pedestrian interval is an advanced walk signal for pedestrians, meaning they get the walk signal a little bit before the vehicles traveling in the same direction get a green light. There are other very simple things that communities can do to improve pedestrian safety, such as restriping crosswalks, making lanes a little narrower and restriping them so that cars receive some visual signals that there is a complicated environment and that they should slow their travel speeds and pay attention to the potential for crossing pedestrians.
I wish that more people considered the fact that we are all pedestrians. The reality is every single person is a pedestrian, probably every single day. And I wish that more people knew, one, just how big the risk is. You know, we have lost about 6,700 people in 2020 alone. That's a big number. And I'm not sure that people really appreciate just how much vulnerability people have on the road and how much responsibility we have every time we use a public roadway.
Your decisions can have a lasting impact
on your life
and the lives of others.